What's up, Scrolgers? It's Nerp here, and welcome to my first video I'm recording in 2015. So 2014 was a pretty good year, and hopefully 2015 can top that even. Bully No Mates revealed the winners of the Golden Bunny Awards on r/scrolls, so you guys can go check that out. It should be still on the top of Reddit. I'll try to remember to have a link to those in the description of this video in case, like, you're watching this in the distant future when it's not on the front page of Reddit anymore. Or by distant future, I mean like a week or something. But yeah, the reason I mentioned that is because I am humbled to see that I was voted so highly in pretty much every category. Actually, you guys voted me to actually won two categories: Content Creator of the Year and Player of the Year. For Player of the Year, I'm a little bit surprised because QQ came in second, and I do think that, like, there's no question that PewQ is a stronger player than I. I probably have like a 30% or 25% win rate against that guy. And if you notice that whenever he plays a tournament, he like usually wins it. I don't have the best tournament success. Obviously, I'm like the king of ranked. The past year I've just been like at number one more than anybody else. So that might have been why people voted for me, because I have consistent success throughout the year. But I think that's just because I played more than PewQ this year. PewQ, whenever he starts to play, he just shoots to number one or something, like right now. And I tried to get back to number one, and I lost like a couple matches, so I'm down to number four, but I'm not too low. I'm still 1880. But, so yeah, I do think that guy is better player than I. But still, I'm just honored to be recognized as one of the best content creators and players of the game. Did not think I would be at this point a year and a half ago. So I thank you all to that. It's really a product of how awesome the whole community is. So yeah, hopefully Scrolls reaches its potential and gets the player base it deserves in 2015. So enough of my rambling. Actually, I have one more thing to ramble on. Sorry about that. You might notice a couple videos ago, I probably had like almost 400,000 gold. I'm now at 216,000 because I've been spending a lot of gold crafting. I officially have a tier 3 set of common scrolls. So if I go to, I guess you could see all the scrolls. If you go to store, black market, and sell, you could see your scrolls better. And then I'll go rarity, common, and tier. I don't know why the tier thing is an L. I guess because tier, the T was taken for type. I don't know why they chose L, probably for some reason. So commons, tier 3. If you notice, every common in the game, I have 3 tier 3s of it now. I spent a lot of gold to do that. By my rough calculations, it costs about 400,000 gold to do that. So yeah, I think tier 3 sets are they're just crazy. Like, if you're going for a regular play set, you just need 3 of every scroll, right? If you're going for a tier 3 play set, you need 27 of every scroll. So yeah, now I have at least 27 of every common. I traded the extras to my other account, and I'm pretty happy now that I did that. Feels more organized, and now I can start working on the uncommons and rares, which obviously are going to be lots more expensive than the commons, but it won't be as much work and time consuming crafting them because there's less uncommons and rares than commons. So yeah, that's all that, furthering my collection. And I'm going to play, to celebrate the first video of 2015, we're going to play some Highlander. Zadrim was kind enough to play, so let's head right into that. Alright guys, good luck, have fun to Zadrim, whatever, and I have an interesting starting hand. I mean, I can go straight for a Quake and then a Jarl. probably clear most of his board and then have an amazing creature on the board. But he could easily just overwhelm me before that. I'm going to draw a new starter hand. Hopefully I get some lower drops. And I guess this is a bit better. I guess I'm going to go for growth. Because I have a nice... I have a whatever, one health wall, two cost, okay creature, and then I can get some ramp. So I'm going to go for growth first. And then desperation is going to go. I'll play the junkyard. I know it's a bad wall, but it probably is going to come in handy. Because he might not have anything to like in Highlander, less likely to have something. Alright, so he's going to get some ramp out of that. And I'm going to get rid of the Wing Spear. Early game won't have Dominion. And I'm just going to play the Outcast Herbal as soon as I can. Alright. So, both the Greylock Outcast and Flesh Animate are going to take a while to get to. Energy Siphon means you're a 3-3-2. Alright, there we go. Royal Spearman's a nice draw there. I'm just going to... Or not really. For a second I thought he was in growth. I don't know why. I will get rid of the Flesh Animator for... Sure, I'll go for growth. And I'm going to play it right here. I'm going to move up. This guy's... I want him to take something out. Hopefully, Zaytrim doesn't have like a spark or a soul seal for it. That would be very, very, very bad. And this next turn, I'm probably just going to go for order. So I will be a little bit annoying. Or the decay. I mean, I think the Outcast is actually better for Highlander because I could probably heal him often. I'll just go for order because I want to get that Royal Spearman out next turn. So I'm sacrificing a bit of resource efficiency here, kind of, because I could be going for all the resources. All right, he just plays a gun out of baton. But I am going to be able to get rid of this Trouble Moro, and it doesn't get him any kind of growth. I'm going to get rid of the Outcast here and just play the Spearman. And I'll play the Spearman here. So I'm able to get rid of his Memorial without it actually helping him. And neither of us have any wild yet, so yeah. We both have very little scrolls. Okay, he doesn't have a play. Languid. I wish I could play that, but not right now. Clandestine Orchard. Who knows, that could be huge. But I'll put, I don't want you to die. I'll just stop him from attacking a little bit. Alright, not too bad. I'm a little hesitant about playing the Clandestine Orchard because it could end up helping him more than me, because this is... Both of our decks are the same scrolls. I mean, might just... The creatures we play. Just depends whose creatures in their hand. Alright, well, Budding Vetter, I think, is a fine draw. I'll sacrifice the Mortar for scrolls. And... I realized maybe I should have gotten for resources there, so I could play for growth, so I can play the Budding Vetter and Clandestine Orchard to make him attack and kill that. But then this will probably attack because he'll probably have something to play. I'm just gonna run away. I don't want this to hurt me at all. I'll take my control of the center of the board. And Budding Vetter's scrolls like Budding Vetter that have synergy with other scrolls are not as good in Highlander because they're not good on their own. Like a 1-2-3 for 3 is just pretty bad. But if I draw some bees, who knows, it could help. Honorable Journal, it's gonna take a very long time to play that. I'm gonna go for Decay. Because right now, I'm gonna finally try to get Wild. He already has Wild, which means it's good that I control the board, it looks like. And there he plays a Cursemonger. So that's the first, like, really strong creature on the field. I guess it's not that much stronger than a Royal Spearman. I'm gonna go for Sickening Fumes, could be very useful. I'm gonna get rid of the Clandestine Orchard. I'm gonna go for energy now. Okay. So if he tries to come down and like engage me, I could just Sickening Fumes. Thought Trap on him, so he's not going to be attacking for a while. Oblivion Seeker. Yeah, I'm not going to Sicken Fumes. I'm gonna let him just like destroy this junkyard. I'm gonna move down. I'm gonna move down. And I'm going to go for Wild, but I'm not gonna play that Watcher yet. Actually, maybe I should have kept the Sicken Fumes. I don't know. I'm gonna go like this. So we're basically giving him this junkyard if he wants to kill it, but then I have things that I would move up and destroy stuff with. So that's not too bad. And he goes with Curse on the Spearman. So now hopefully he doesn't have like a Brain Lice or Infectious Blight. That'd be the worst. We'll see. He goes for Resources. So he's going to play probably a 5 drop in Decay. There's a Lifestealer. So he has both a Cursemonger and a Lifestealer on the board. That is really scary. Paternal Sword is nice. But I'm going to be able to get a Stormrunner on the board. I'll get rid of the Watcher. I mean, it doesn't really matter. I'm probably going to have to end up sacrificing the Oblivion Seeker as well. But I'll play the Stormrunner. And that is, I think, a very big play also. Because I'm also probably going to Eternal Sword it maybe soon. And four attack moving lobbers are powerful. Oculus Cannon. Okay. Well, this is scary. I'm gonna get rid of the Oblivion Seeker for Scrolls. I can't play it like anytime soon. Boghound. Ugh. Welp. I have to protect this Stormrunner. If this Stormrunner survives, he can actually deal a lot of damage. But then if I try to move everybody down, I might just have to give up the Royal Spearman and the Spudding Gutter. I think that's gonna have to happen. So let's just play the Boghound here. And I'm going to keep these guys on this row so that maybe the Stormrunner is going to be able to pick off like both the Cursemonger and the Oculus Cannon. That'd be really nice. So hopefully he keeps that Cursemonger in the same spot. Doesn't look like he is though. Or maybe, oh, he actually did. So he definitely should have moved up. So now I'm going to be able to take out both of those guys and kill this Outcast. So that's a very, very big play for me. And I'm gonna go for Decay so I can start going for more Wilds here. Get rid of the Supercharged. Supercharged is not that good of a scroll. So I will go like this. Unfortunately, I'll have to keep my Boghound down there. And Earthborn Keeper is not amazing because I'm probably not gonna play like a creature every turn. So he's not always gonna have much attack. But whatever. Like, Eternal Sword on him would be pretty good. I'll play him in the back. And then I'll Eternal Sword this. And should I rattle him? I mean, chances that he plays a Lingering Spell are so slim. May as well rattle him and get my own Lingering Spell. Sure. Field of Strife. Well, that's not going to do me any good. Alright, well, now I'm going to want to protect that Stormrunner. It's 4 attack moving lobber. Gotta protect him. We'll see if he, we'll see if Zadrum tries to engage Mary. So he's just holding the middle of the board, so I'm gonna have a chance to run away. And I'll get rid of this Fields of Strife. I have no knights on the board. Transposition. Ooh. Deathcap Berserk. I could haste any of my things. Oh, I can make any of my things attack. I can make you attack, but then you can only kill the Lifestealer. And then I don't want you to die. I'd rather you stay around. If I Deathcap Berserk you, I'm going to kill this. I'm going to kill that, but then you're just going to die. I mean, there's not really a big point in Deathcap Berserking, so I'm just going to hide down here. I have a transposition for next turn, so I can move my Stormrunner wherever on the board he can. I just hope my opponent doesn't have like a burn or something. That'd be terrible. I'm just going to play the Asherunner up there. Probably won't do much good, that Asherunner, because he only has one attack without any enchantments. But he's another warm body in the board, which is definitely very important in this game type. Yeah, he's moving down like that. Mystic is a very powerful creature. And my Stormrunner survives another turn. And so he'll be able to take out this Boom Reaver. Gusty is really nice. Should I transposition with something? I mean, it doesn't really matter. I'm still taking out one creature. I'm gonna, should I just save the transposition? If I hit it there, I mean, yeah, I mean, this is, I'm just gonna take out the Boom River and not transposition. I'm gonna keep the Deathcap Berserk. I'm gonna get rid of the Gusty for, I mean, Gusty's nice. I can go for resources and play the Gusty next turn. I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna sacrifice the transposition for wild. And just do nothing this turn. Okay. So now next turn I could play the Gusty Azuler. And that will be a nice big creature that, yeah. Lifestealer is fully healed now, so it's certainly a threat. I might Deathcap Berserk this turn on my Stormrunner if it's a really good play and he like clumps up. But I don't want to just do it to get rid of like one creature, because I don't, because then that means the Stormrunner is going to go away soon. A Deathcap Berserk enchanted on this would kill it. So, I don't know what I'm going to do. Is he going to stay in the middle? If he stays in the middle, I might just run away from both sides. Rot Eater. Well, I think I could actually take out this Lifestealer, right? 1, 2, 3. If I get another creature, I could play. You know what? Should I get rid of the Gusty? We're getting rid of the Gusty, guys. I mean, I could play the, I could play the Deathcap to get rid of, but I almost want to get play the Deathcap to get rid of this Illmire Rod Eater. I just have to attack it and do that. I have to use Deathcap for that, though. I'm going to get rid of the Gusty. Restless Bones, Earthen Mirth, wow. Earthen Mirth on this is huge. Earthen Mirth on that is going to give you 4 attack, and I can get it to 5 attack. I don't know if that's the play for this turn, though. The play for this turn, I could go Ragged Wolf, Earthen Mirth, which wouldn't give me enough damage to kill this Lochling Brood. I'm just going to get rid of this. What do I get rid of? I'm going to get rid of the Rot Eater while I... Nah. Yeah, the Rot Eater while I can. And then just run away. Okay. Because chances are I get another enchantment that I can kill this Lochling Brood with. But that may have been a huge mistake if I don't draw like a nice enchantment to get rid of. I always have an Earthen Mirth to get rid of this. I'd rather play an Earthen Mirth on my own creature, though.
He moves up, runs away from the Storm Runner, and kills my Ash Runner. At least the Ash Runner helped in destroying the Rod Eater, but we essentially played two scrolls to get rid of it then. Wow. Jarl Urholt. Can I afford to just wrap right to it? The next turn I would have two turns of doing nothing. No, I can't afford it. Look at my idols here. He might be able to take out my idols soon. I'm gonna sacrifice the, or actually this turn I can just Ragged Wolf Earthenworth to get rid of this Locking Brood. We'll see if we get a better thing. I think I'm just gonna go with the Ragged Wolf Earthenworth. I wish I could play the Earthenmirth. I wish I could play the Earthenmirth on my keeper, but whatever. And then also play the Royal Skirmisher, which is great. So that's pretty good. I could have just Earthenmirth the Brood to get rid of it, but I guess I'd rather have a 5 attack creature on the board. And it's going to take two turns of doing basically nothing to get that Urholt out, so it's going to be a big sacrifice. Iron Ogre. Wow, we have some big drops here. I'm going to go sacrifice Ogre Scrolls. Alright. You know, let's just pile it on. Let's move in. I'm going to try to protect. I'll try to protect what's going on here. Also play Vilda. And a Warding Stone here. And I don't really feel the need to play Baleful Witch. So now I have Dominion, which means this spot count is 4 attack, but it might just die this turn. We will see. So yeah, I like my position now because even if he's able to kill the Storm Runner or something, I have all this other stuff attacking. And vice versa. So it is indeed looking like it is in our favor. We both have, actually no, he doesn't have Dominion yet. Yeah, I got my nice slew of creatures. We both have about the same amount of resources. All right, so is he gonna have an enchantment to go to the Storm Runner? Vitriol Aura, so he does. Oh, that's tough. Next turn, I'm gonna have to give up something. Ooh, Roasted Bean Potion. First of all, let's see. Two and then five. All right, well, I can't get rid of the Mystic, but I'm gonna get rid of the Lifestealer. I'm going to give up this Earthborn Keeper. Keep that Rusty move. I'm just going to try to go for the Jarl now. Let you die and kill you. And I have a Roasted Bean Potion next turn to make any of my creatures attack if I want them to. Alright. I'm pretty close to lethal too. He goes for Scrolls. And a Knight Sergeant. And he's gonna run away from that Vilda. Okay, but I don't mind because I have this Warding Stone protecting my creatures. Overdrive. Alright, that's just gonna let him get rid of that. Hopefully he doesn't have like a spark or something. Is that game if I Roasted Bean Potion this or that this guy goes to 8 attack? Oh no, this is Roasted Bean Potion is a spell. I could sacrifice the scrolls, just hope for some kind of enchantment I could play, and then that's game. But I think I should. I don't know. Yeah, I'm gonna go for growth. I want to play the Urholt next turn. I'm still gonna Roasted Bean Potion though, so I can take out his creature as soon as it comes out. And I'll, instead of dealing a bunch of damage to one idol, I will take out an idol. So now I have to deal. I have to destroy one more idol, and next turn I'll have a Jarl Urholt. Which, unless he has like a Vaunt Spiritual Damning Curse, then I should be able to win pretty quickly. I'm Metal Wonder in front. And is that going to be game? Not quite, but I'm going to get this Jarl out. Go to the Owl. And boom, get the pseudo Crimson Bull out. And now Zadrim's just busted. There's not much he could do at this point with that Jarl standing right there. Whoops! I set up right for Thunder Surge and he had one. My mistake. That'd be awesome if I got two champions out of this game, but I don't have nearly enough resources to play the Seamstress. Seed of Insurgency. Well, let's do this. Oh, actually. Regenerator. Is the agent just gonna surrender? Regenerator does one direct idle damage. So if I played that on Vilda, I mean, it would deal the damage to me, though. I mean, like, Vilda's attack would go up if I played on my own creature. I'm gonna keep that Regenerator. I have the game now. Redeploy, Vicious Strike, Regenerator. I did actually, that Regenerator heals him. Whatever. But, GG. So, that'll be it for today, guys. Like the video, enjoy, subscribe for more content like this, and happy New Year.